Hello, welcome to the next session of electromagnetism, that is, it is based on nature of magnetic field. At the end of this session, learners are able to elaborate the production of magnetic field in straight conductor, solenoid and toroid. Identify the factors affecting magnetic field strength in different cases. So, to understand the magnetic field produced in the straight conductor, let take a loop of conductor passing through a cardboard, that is one cardboard, and a loop of conductor is passing through this cardboard, which is supplied by a battery, okay. So, as soon and take some iron particles and spread the iron particles on the cardboard. If we switch on this supply, then we'll observe that the iron particle placed on the cardboard, they form, they arranged in the circular nature around the conductor. Okay, so take a long wire and bend it, form a circle, pass it through the cardboard such that half of wire is above it and remaining part of the wire is below the cardboard. Join the free ends of the wire to battery through a plug key. Insert the key and pass the current. Sprinkle iron fillings on the cardboard and tap gently. Note that pattern of iron fillings that emerge on the cardboard. Repeat the experiment by reversing the direction of magnetic flow of current. Repeat the experiment by increasing the strength of current. Repeat the experiment by increasing the number of turns of the coil. Repeat the experiment by reducing the radius of the coil. So we have to repeat this experiment by increasing the flow of current, by increasing the strength of by changing the direction of current, by increasing the number of turns of this coil, and by reducing the radius of this coil. So what are the observation? It concentric circles are formed, that iron fillings will form a concentric circles which is the centered at the point which wire passes through the cardboard. The center of this circle lies at the wire which passes through the cardboard. The lines near the center of the loop are almost straight. The lines near to the center of the loop are almost straight, and the magnetic field at the center of the loop is perpendicular to the plane of loop. Okay, so the magnetic field at the center of loop is perpendicular to the plane of loop. So if we observe here, so magnetic field is perpendicular to the plane of loop. Okay, next, the concentric circle becomes larger as we move away from the circle. If we move away from the circle, this concentric circle becomes larger. On increasing the strength of current, the number of lines of forces increases. The number of lines of forces will increase if we increase the number of current. The number of lines of forces around the coil increases. Okay. So what is the conclusion from this? The magnetic lines of forces around the straight conductor carrying current are concentric circle whose center lies on wire. That is, the magnetic field produced is forms a concentric circle which center is lying on the wire. The magnitude of magnetic field, that is the strength of magnetic field produced by a wire, is directly proportional to the current passing through the wire. Means if the current is increases, magnitude of magnetic field strength is also increases. It is inversely proportional to the distance of the point from the wire. Okay, so as we move away from the center of the wire, the magnetic field starts decreasing. Means distance is increases, the magnetic field starts decreasing. That is, it is inversely proportional to the distance. Greater the current in the wire, stronger the magnetic field, and greater the distance of a point from a wire, magnetic field produced is weaker. Okay, so how the magnetic field is produced in a circular coil? So is a circular coil take how will form a circular coil? A circular coil consists 20 or more tons. Okay, in a circular coil will take 20 or more tons of insulated copper wire closely wound together. So keep in mind the wire should be what insulated enamel coated wire, that is insulated copper wire closely wound together, just like windings in the machines. When a current is passed through the circular coil, when the current starts passing through its circular coil, magnetic field is produced around it. The lines of force are circular near the wire, but they become straight and parallel towards the middle of the coil. That is, magnetic field is circular near the coil, and at the center of the coil, at the center of the coil, we'll observe that the magnetic lines of forces are almost straight. At the center of the coil, all lines of force aid each other, due to which strength of magnetic field is increases. Okay, so if we observe at the center all fluxes are adding, hence magnetic field is stronger inside the coil and it is weak on the outside of the coil. The polarity of solenoid can be changed by reverse, the coil carrying a current behaves as a thin disc magnet which faces north pole and other is south pole. Okay, so it forms a north pole and south poles. How the strength of this magnetic field produced varies? The strength of magnetic field produced by a conductor carrying a circular coil can be increased by increasing the number of turns. Okay, so strength of magnetic field is proportional to the strength of magnetic field is proportional to the number of turns of the wire. If the number of turns are increases, strength of magnetic field is increases. By increasing the current flowing through the coil, if we increase the current flowing through the coil, then also magnetic field strength increases. By decreasing the radius of coil, if we decrease the radius of coil, that is, if we decrease the radius of coil, means if the radius is, if this radius is lower, the stronger will be the magnetic field inside the solenoid. Okay, so these are the factor affecting the magnetic field of a circular coil. So let us take example of solenoid. What is happening inside the solenoid? Solenoid means this coil is wound around a material. A solenoid is a long coil shaped like a cylinder and containing a large number of closed turns insulated copper wire. So in solenoid there is a long coil containing the large number of closed turns. The turns are very close to each other because and the copper which is used, it is insulated. When a current is passed through the solenoid, when the current is passed through this solenoid, it produces a magnetic field around it. It produces the magnetic field around it. The magnetic field is as shown in above figure. It is along the axis of solenoid, it is almost constant magnitude and direction. So how to calculate the direction of this? Okay, so we studied the right hand thumb rule. In case of right hand thumb rule, the thumb is indicating the direction of current, then curl finger is indicating the direction of magnetic field. So we can make this law opposite in case of solenoid. So let us consider that in solenoid, the curl finger are indicating the direction of current, then thumb is indicating the direction of magnetic field, that is north pole. Keep in mind, okay, place put keep your curl finger in the direction of current flowing through the solenoid, then thumb will indicate the direction of magnetic field. It is the magnetic lines of forces inside the solenoid are nearly parallel, so inside the solenoid it is nearly parallel to each other, and it is parallel to the axis of solenoid. It is what? Parallel to the axis of a solenoid. A solenoid when suspended freely, if such solenoid be suspended freely, it aligns itself in north and south direction. So that just like a needle, it behaves like a needle. It aligns itself between the north and south direction. One end of solenoid will act as a north pole and other end will act as a south pole. The polarity of solenoid can be changed. So solenoid, in case of solenoid, we can change the polarity by reversing the direction of current. Okay, so if you reverse the direction of current, the polarity of the solenoid can be changed. So on which factor the strength of solenoid strength of magnetic field in the solenoid, it depends. The strength of magnetic field produced by a current carrying solenoid depends on number of turns. Okay, so as the larger the number of turns, greater is the magnetism produced. It is also depends on the strength of current. When the current increases, magnetism also increases. Okay, and it depends on nature of core material. Okay, so whatever the core material which is used to make the solenoid, it is also depending upon that. If we use the soft iron core for the solenoid, it produces strongest magnetic field. In case of soft iron, it will produce strongest magnetic field. So next is what toroid. So what is a toroid? Toroid is a solenoid wrapped around with its end connected. So in a solenoid, the core is totally form a circular in nature. A toroid is a coil of insulated or enameled wire wound on the donut shaped form made to powdered made up of powdered iron. Using the powdered iron core, we can wound the wire on this enameled coated copper wire around this core. The toroid is used to act as an inductor in electronic circuit. So this toroid is used to form a inductor in electronic circuit, especially in low frequency. Especially this can be used in low frequencies, whereas comparatively large inductance are necessary. In case of low frequencies, if we require a large inductance, we can design using the toroid. In toroid, all magnetic flux is contained in the core material because of core has no ends. Okay, so all magnetic flux is confined with the core material. Okay, so that is only small part will be happen in the leakage, otherwise all flux is linked inside this core. The confinement of flux prevents the external magnetic field from the affecting behavior of toroid. So magnetic field effect from the outside is very less in case of toroid. Okay, unlike the magnetic field of solenoid, the magnetic field inside the toroid is non-uniform and decreases as 1 by r. Okay, inside, if we move away from the away from the center, it starts decreasing. Okay, it starts magnetic field inside the toroid is non-uniform. It is non-uniform in nature at the center. It is highest value and it decreases with increases in the radius. Thank you.